Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit createandcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and quote the item number on your screen.
A very good afternoon. It's Sunday, it's 5 o'clock, and welcome to the Cake Academy. Yet again, we've got an hour of fantastic inspiration for you. We're going to take you through step by step some great ideas to decorate your cakes. Now, this show is in association with Cake Academy, of course, Cake Masters, and it's something you can get involved in online. A little bit more about that a little bit later on. And also with the show, remember, you don't have to miss it, because you can series link this for every Sunday. So if you want to catch every single show, you want to record it to look back another time, you can do that as well. So all of those things. Now, throughout the show, we're going to show some special techniques. Now, you will be able to purchase most of the items on the show. If you don't see it, it will be on our website, createandcraft.tv. But what we're going to do is we're going to take you step by step. Now, when you do see something you like, if you're brand new to the show, and this show is really about new customers, people who maybe not paper crafters and people are more into their caking and cake designing and decorating, you will see the details appear on your screen. They're going to come up any moment now. We call it the L here in home shopping. It's been the same for many years, but it just gives you the opportunity to see everything. For example, the item number, what the item's called, how much it's going to cost, and down the bottom where you can go and buy it. And pretty much that'll happen throughout the show. We're not going to get a feature on that too much. We're going to leave you to do your shopping, but I will help you along the way. But what we will be doing is we'll be inspiring you. Remember, this is the Cake Academy. It's Sunday, it's 5 o'clock. Let's crack on. So here we are then, ready and raring to go, and all we need now is our resident expert, and today it's the lovely Rosella. Hello my darling, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
Now we're going to approach the Cake Academy from a slightly different angle today, aren't we?
We are. We're going to transfer our paper crafting skills to our cakes.
Because a lot of people may have seen you and seen you doing your tattered dies and all those sort of things, but there are a lot of items that people don't realise are in the paper crafting world that can be used on cakes.
Absolutely. Dies, for one thing. All our dies are foods. Safe, okay. And incidentally dishwasher safe as well, which is
Now we don't often hear that on shows.
I know, it's
because
got something
we don't
to talk
think
about,
to say about it, do we?
No.
Now, as you can see on your screens right now, we're going to be not just decorating the cake, but having things to decorate around the cake, the presentation. I'm a great believer in presentation, as you can probably understand. Big fan of that. And it doesn't have to be that difficult, does it, Rosella?
No, it's really easy. And I know that often I will paint on cakes and people think, oh no, don't want to do that, we're not painting today. Really simple today. Stenciling.
Let's crack on. As I said to you before, if you'd like to order anything on the show as we go along, the details will appear on the screen. So then, what's going to be our first thing?
So we're going to start with stencils. Now, I've brought stencils before, and often, if you're using a fondant icing, what I would say would be to place the stencil on and to roll it. But okay. I've got a royal icing here, so it's really hard. I'm not going to roll it into that. So what I'm actually going to do is just stencil with our rainbow dust powders on top. So when you get your stencil home, it's probably got a border on it like that. I don't want that hard edge border, so first thing I'm actually going to do is cut that off. So, just so that I can get a really soft edge.
Oh, hang on.
I know.
This is not something we'd normally do. Hacking into your stencil.
It's a tool, isn't it? At the end of the day, it's a tool, and it's what works for you. So, I'm going to leave one side of the border on. So, if I do perhaps want to do quite a distinct border around,
yes.
I'm still going to have that hard edge there. So, I'll leave one side on, but I want a soft edge on this one. So, let's just take that.
So, again, this is, again, if you are someone who's watching and maybe is watching as a paper crafter and you think to yourself, well, I'm not very good at art, or I'm not very inspired with cakes, you don't need to be.
Nope.
You've probably got the tools in the drawer, haven't you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, all I'm going to use is some brushes.
Okay.
And I'm going to use what we call our rainbow dust. So these are a cake colouring. This is what I do actually use to paint cakes as well, but I use an edible medium to bind it then. I'm not going to do that now.
This is all edible now?
These are all absolutely edible. Okay. And you'll get some beautiful colours. I'm just going to put it on a bit of kitchen towel just to keep the counter slightly tidy. And then
good effort.
It won't last, not at all, will it? But it's a start. And then decide where on my cake. So what I'm going to do on my cake, I'm going to have some ivy on there, I'm going to have some flowers on there, a little bit of trellis to break up this large white area.
Okay.
So I'm just actually going to hold it in place. And then I use the lid of these, actually. So what I tend to do is just pop a little bit in the lid so that you can then just put a bit up the brush and then choose where you then want to stencil.
So this is a dabbing effect this time, isn't it?
Now, you can paint through these, like, you know, sort of more of a brush if you want to. Okay. It's entirely up to you. You're just really laying that colour down.
Now, you could actually buy pre-iced cakes, can't you, like this, in the stores and stuff?
Very much like this, Dean, yes.
Very much like this one, isn't it? So I know you like to do it all yourself.
No, anyone who knows me knows that I do not bake. I don't actually eat a huge amount of cake. My friend bakes for me, Anita. She bakes me homemade cake, and that's pretty much all I eat.
So you have staff to bake your cake.
Yes, she'll appreciate that staff.
I totally get where you're coming from there.
Now, as you're going along, because we haven't rolled it into the icing, it means that we can actually lift it to see. Yeah, isn't that nice? It's really effective,
and again,
isn't it?
And again, it doesn't always have to be even, does it?
No.
It can be quite braided.
And I'm going to miss a little bit out. I'm going to sort of come round the corner a bit.
Okay. So there's a bit of a sort of, I suppose, suck it and see here, really, isn't it?
I think that's it. I mean, yeah, we're sort
play.
Of... Yeah, and designing it. And I think, actually, I'm happy with that at the moment.
Cool,
it's quite nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just that little bit on there. So a little bit of extra interest in the background there, because there's no texture on this cake. It's perfectly plain, isn't it? So that's the beginning. So I'm just going to put the lid on there.
And also, stencils are something that we completely understand, don't we? We use stencils at school with sponges and things. So it's in our psyche, almost.
Yes.
So bringing them to cake pretty much makes sense, doesn't it, if you think about it?
Definitely. And you'll see I'm not actually going to clean this brush at all. This was a new clean brush, but all I'm doing is wiping it away. I've got another one there if I want to choose to use a really light colour.
Okay.
So get a selection of brushes. Yeah.
And all types of brushes and tools, they've got the Wilton tools and all these things, again, if I can remind you, are on our website.
Yep.
So if you want to go and check out tools and bits and pieces, cratecraft.tv is the place to go. So then, there's the first stencil.
So that's it. That's my stencil. Now I want to make a flower.
Okay.
Okay. So we've got wafer paper. So have a look at that. So this is paper, but it is edible paper.
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Is it like those flying saucers you used to buy?
It is. Just like...
Is it?
I had one of those yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah, I don't like them. I don't know why. But, yeah, they stick to the roof of your mouth, don't they?
Yes, they do, dear.
And then...
They're under your plate.
That's cheeky. but then I was in the shed decorating these cakes and the dog was mithering me because he could smell all the icing and everything.
Oh, yes.
So I thought, oh, well, I'll give him some of this wafer paper. So he got it all stuck there and all stuck there and it was everywhere. Absolutely everywhere.
The dog thing, so you know, give something, I'd like, if you give dog, and they accidentally pick up a sweet and then they get...
Yeah, that's it. Nice.
What a wonderful thing.
Lovely.
Don't give this to the dog.
Yes. Well, it's so up to you, but it might be messy.
Now, before we go any further, you're using a stencil this time.
I'm using a dye. So the dye that I'm using is one of the Lavish Lilies. There's three dyes in the Lavish Lily set, but it makes a really great size rose, this one.
Now, I assume, based on my experience in these shows before, and the details on the screen if you'd like to get this, if you're using these, you shouldn't use them for both. We just keep a set.
That's
aside
right.
For
we
cake,
recommend
yeah?
a set for cakes as well. And also, what we've got on the show is the Cut Tidy.
Okay.
So I mean, I've got some of that here, but it's transparent, so I can't find it. Is that it? No. I put it here ready. Don't it?
It's transparent, so I can't see it.
So I'm actually going to put...
Right,
now,
okay.
I don't need it for this particular dye, but if I was going to use maybe the cupcake stencil dye or the sunflower doily dye where there's lots of little bits, it's just the same as the paper. Just put it in there.
So, OK, for people who don't know, because we've got some new viewers with cake candy, what is Cut Tidy? Explain
so
what that is.
What it is, it's this sort of polythene almost. I don't know what it's actually made from, sheet. And you put whatever you're die cutting within it, and then your die is going to go underneath it.
Okay.
So the die doesn't actually touch the
paper. So it cuts that inside, even though it's inside the... Now, we don't understand that technology,
no,
do we?
No, it's magic. We call it magic, basically.
It definitely works.
Yes.
We'll see in just a second. But it means everything stays contained inside there. And once again, I'd say, if you're getting Cut Tidy for foods, food things, that's technical, isn't it? I'd keep it for that.
I'd leave it in the baking drawer.
Keep your cake and dyes and the edibles... And obviously paper for paper, that's what we want to say.
I'm not going to use it for the lavish lily because it's such a clean cut this day. Okay. It'll go straight through it. So all we need to do then, now on my crossover, I've currently got it at setting 4 and I've got a magnetic sheet on there.
Now can I, obviously, once you've done this, you'll sort of, you'll get a feel for this.
Yes, you will.
Dies. But that's not a very hard pressure,
is not it? At all, because you don't need it, because it cuts absolutely beautifully, as you can see.
Edible flowers.
That's what we've got.
Straight up, unbelievable.
Absolutely.
Unbelievable.
So, you know, if you're not a sugar paste expert and you want a cake with flowers on like we've got
Should we show you this? Because, just like to drag your attention, this cake over here is stunning. Not only has it got the stencil that Rosella was using a few months ago, but look at all these little flowers here are all edible and all made from those dyes. So, you see, you don't have to be mega skilled because this technique and these techniques will make you look better than you are.
They certainly
will. And that's
what
we're after, isn't it?
Absolutely. That's what we like, to look great.
But and also time-saving, was it?
Well, I think that's it, because now I've actually had those ones. I deliberately cut those a week ago and left them out because I wanted to see what effect it would have sort of in the atmosphere. Mm. None whatsoever. They're absolutely perfect.
The same as they were.
Yeah, if you're doing a cake and you want lots and lots of flowers cascading down, great. Do it
How
in advance.
How have you stuck them together?
Edible glue.
Okay.
Okay, so there should be some on the website. What have I got there? I've got this particular
Sugarcraft.
One.
We've got all the edible glues on the website.
There's several different ones. Okay. Again, back to the bit of kitchen towel underneath. And I'm going to go back to those rainbow dust because I want to colour this. I don't want white flowers. Okay. I want pink flowers. So back to the rainbow dust.
Now, the edible water paper we've just put on your screens. Be aware that on the screens, we're going to try and put as many different products on the screens as we can. But don't worry, at the end of each demonstration, what I'll try to do is give you a bit of an update and I'll give you a bit of a shopping list.
Yeah.
So if you did miss something, then we'll recap at the end. So don't panic if you're missing things. Just relax and enjoy the show.
Okay, and then all I'm doing is just colouring it.
Okay.
And it's going to stick to it. You don't have to put any medium on there,
this
no glue.
This is like
glue.
A candy floss colour.
It's lovely, isn't it? I like it.
Reminds me of the fun fair.
And you don't have to be even. Now, we've actually got some tools on the show, and I found these particularly useful. Actually, just holding it in place for one thing.
Okay.
They're great for sort of giving some shape and dimension to the petals as well. But they really
As you would with paper?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Little bit more careful. Not quite so rough as you would be with perhaps some paper. Treat it like parchment paper, Dean.
It's a delicate flower.
Delicate flower. Now, flowers tend to have colour on both sides, don't they?
Oh, how inconvenient.
Yeah, so let's just pop some on that side as well.
Simple as that. And again, there is no painting technique here.
No. Nope.
It's getting the product onto the product, isn't
it,
really?
That's all it is. We're just colouring it.
And this is lovely. This is what the Cake Academy is all about, Lizanne, because you may have watched the Cake Academy in the past and seen moulding and sculpting and figurines and all sorts of things to yourself. I'm going to give that a try, but a bit nerve-wracking. With something like this, what we wanted to do is give everyone a chance, all abilities, and everyone who maybe hasn't even tried cake decorating before, a chance to be able to get a great result. Now, obviously, if you've used dyes before, you'll be really confident with them. So you should be confident in making something that we're going to make today, proving that everyone can decorate cakes. And it's a hugely, hugely popular thing, isn't it?
It is. Well, I think it's just something to be really proud of.
Yeah.
If you're like me and you don't bake, and you're not going to... I just sometimes do. Fruit cakes, I do. But if you... And you haven't got time, it's just putting a little bit of something
Definitely.
Of yourself
yeah.
in that, isn't
yeah.
it?
She doesn't make, but she takes.
Yes.
If there's cakes to be cake about today, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a lovely day.
Yes,
one of our guests
have
bought a lovely fruit cake today, which was beautiful. We all ate that, didn't we?
Yeah. There's another one there. We've got lots of cake, we've got cupcakes, we've got everything.
We've got plenty of cakes today. But isn't it funny though, because when you make cakes, and maybe you've made cupcakes and you've been involved in the sort of the trend over the last few years of making your own cupcakes and muffins and that sort of thing, it's so much nicer if you can go to the next level.
Yes.
And decorate them for your house, don't you?
Why not? I mean, we've got, I think, I wanted, when I came in and said we want a garden party, we've got a bit of a garden party going on here, but do that, you know.
Yeah.
When
we've got a, like a cake dome in the kitchen.
Yeah.
It's ever so sad when it's empty.
Yes.
I walk in the door sometimes and something's been going on in the house, you go, and you walk in. When the cake dome's full of cake, regardless of what it is, it's really exciting. But there's something about that being wrapped or something on the top or a flat. And
yes.
you're really special. And you go and buy those, which we have in the past, they cost a fortune.
Yeah.
So doing it yourself, well, you get that wonderful thing. Your family walks in, there's all cakes available,
yep.
and they look special.
I think that's it. And people look at it and think, oh, yeah, you've made a bit of an effort for me, and I really like
parties,
that.
Kids' parties, your parties, you know.
Yeah.
If you can bake well, but you're not very good at decorating, this is the show for you. And don't forget, later on we'll be talking about the Cake Masters subscription that you can get involved with, which means it gives you inspiration on a monthly basis. Again, more later. So
and again, I keep some, usually kitchen scissors, I don't know what I've got on these. This rose, I've actually done a video of this rose, and it's on the... No, it's not. It's on the, what do you call it, the Academy on the website.
Craft Academy.
It is Craft Academy, isn't
it?
Yeah,
it's the Craft Academy on the website.
It is on there. It says exactly the same technique. So if you forget how to do it, don't worry about it. It's there for you. Okay. So you'll need four of the outside shapes to do it. And then on one of them, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to just cut around. Now, on this die, you've actually got the centre, which is sort of semi-perforated, so you know, pretty much circular. It doesn't have to be perfect. So we don't want that bit. That's for the dog.
That's for the dog.
And then... I'm going to cut a little bit of that petal over, and I need some glue now.
We'll stick it back on again.
And then we'll stick it back together again. Now that we've cut it, we'll put it back together again. So I actually liked this one for that.
Do you? So you don't use a brush for this?
No, I use this tool. I thought it was great.
Oh, that's interesting.
With a brush, you tend to get so much on, and with that, you just get a little amount on.
Oh, I see. Clever. Instant dimension.
Absolutely.
I like that technique. So snip half the petal off, cut the centre out.
Otherwise, you're going to have two full petals, and that means it's going to be bulky at some point in
and
your
darker.
Flower. Yeah. So, and if you don't have edible glue, this paper, you can attach it with a little bit of water, but you have to be quite careful how much, and I didn't think I'd be that careful on air. So the next one, we're going to do the same again.
And again, don't have to be particular about these circles and the cutting, do you? Don't be precious.
Not at all. It's just a rough idea. And I'm actually going to take an entire petal out.
Oh, hang on.
And then half a petal again. So this one.
So you've just reduced the size.
That's right.
The same technique.
Yeah,
right, got it.
Absolutely.
Yep.
And let's just pop that together as well. So these are really, really quick to make as well.
How therapeutic is this?
And of course, you can do this with paper as well. So perhaps you, in your dome, you can have your cake decorated, but then you can put little flowers around it as well, couldn't you?
Yeah. Mm. I'll mention that when I get home.
Yes. So if you haven't got enough to do, I'm going to give you this as well.
What do you want to do with them, Lot?
Can you imagine? I'll be wearing
them.
Yes,
that's just what I was
rather
thinking.
Rather than eating them,
definitely.
I'll be wearing them, wouldn't I? Actually, if the truth be told, it'd be me doing the decorating because I'm the one that likes this bit.
But it's so much fun. It's the construction bit of it, isn't it?
Yeah, because it's a bit of a team effort. Because I mean, she does the great baking occasionally because that means it's something she likes to. But I like the messing about. I like the decorating bit.
Oh, it's perfect. Match made in heaven.
Yeah, I do like that actually. It's quite good. I like piping and stuff.
Oh well, that would be perfect.
Yeah. Is that going to fold?
Two petals on that one. It will.
Yeah, oh wow.
No problem. It is quite pliable, this paper. You'd be surprised if you've not worked with it before just how versatile it is and how you can manipulate it. And it just glues really quickly.
So what's the maximum you're going to put on these? Is there a maximum?
Yes. Of actual layers, it's going to be just the four whole flowers, so that I'm going to leave that as a base.
Okay.
Sometimes I'll take it up so that it hasn't got a flat bottom. But to be honest, a flat bottom makes it easier to stand up, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So this one, now, have I got that tool? There we go. There's one of the tools. Can you see it's almost like a pencil? So I find that's really useful then, because this is obviously quite small, just to roll around.
So the tool sets are really, really useful to have.
Yep.
I've done a few cake academies now, and one thing I've noticed that most people, whether they're doing figurines, whether they're doing die cutting, whatever sort of thing they're doing, tools, those little plastic tools, they're all the different ends, well worth getting and well worth going for. And they're on the screen right now. If you want to order yours, all the details, as you can see, to order, call or on the website. Look at that.
And particularly then when you come down to the single petal that you cut out there, so that's really quite tricky to curl. So if you've got something to curl it around like the tool, it's a lot easier. Again, a little bit of glue on there. And then let's just attach that as well.
Oh, a little tiny part in the
centre. Little tiny one, yeah. Now that's going to take a little bit longer. So I've put too much glue on there. So let's just put that on there. You might have to hold that one, Dean, for me. Let me have a look.
I might have to hold it.
No, it's playing nicely. That's
fine. It's playing nicely, lovely. Because the nice thing about edible glue, it does go off quite quickly, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. And then all it is now is assembling it. So back to that one that was almost like the pencil.
So once again, the paper crafters amongst us today watching will totally appreciate this.
Absolutely.
And understand what's going on.
Yep.
But you've just transferred those skills into cake decorating.
Yeah.
Which is fabulous. And that's what the Cake Academy is all about. Transferable skills, new skills, sharing skills, you know, all those things. And if you want to get involved with the Cake Academy, you can always do that on a Sunday at 5 by emailing in, etc. And please remember, so a lot of people like to record the whole
series, as it were. And this is a series of shows that you will be able to watch, and you can series link this. Remember to check that it's on. Remember, it's the Cake Academy on Sunday. Well, always worth a check on your UPG, you know, sort of the list of programmes. Just check it before you get, you know, before it goes to record. I always check it because things happen and programmes change for different reasons. So this shouldn't change, and it doesn't change, but just double check it's recording, because there's nothing worse than going to say, oh, no, the very last episode.
Yes. We've all done it, and we've all been there.
And then you have to find it and download it and catch up on it or something. But don't forget to series link, because Cake Academy is 5 o'clock Sunday evening. What a nice time for cake and tea.
I think it is, isn't it? It's tea time, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's tea time. Nothing? No? OK, then.
Right.
Bring your own. I'll bring a flask next time. I'll bring my tartan flask.
We've got some nice cups. We could make it look nice, couldn't we?
Yeah, we could do.
Now, when you get to the centre, you might find, and I think I will on that, that it stands a little proud.
Okay.
So I'm just going to take the bottom off that. A little bit more off.
So don't be afraid to have a good old snip.
No, not at all.
Do you get a feeling that even if you're someone who's probably done this for the first time, common sense, you look at the flower, you know it doesn't look right.
Yes.
So have a snip about, curl the petals a little bit more. And, you know, obviously you can see above here that this is looking like a flower.
Yeah.
I like the way the glue makes it darker in shade.
It does, doesn't
places.
It? A little bit of shade.
Really
and of course,
works.
With the colours, you could put extra highlights in there. You could put extra shade on there as well. So there's, it's really, really versatile. You could paint them, of course. Now, I don't paint this particular wafer paper with edible medium because it is quite delicate. Just make sure that you're not going to attach it to the paper underneath. I'm going to put it on there just in case.
Yeah, because you'll be using a board at home or something.
Will,
I'm sure you have your little board, like you do for your paper crafting. You have your little board.
Where's my gluey one? There
and sort of
go.
End up crafting in a 6-inch square.
Absolutely.
As always.
It doesn't matter how large your desk is, does it?
No.
It's never going to stay that. That's why I like the crossover. It's got that built-in platform that you have to keep clean. So, and again, this centre one, I'm just going to take that down a little bit because it is going to stand
Lovely.
Quite proud.
Beautiful. And so, this is the sort of thing you can do on your own. You know, in that time when you're experimenting and having a little play, and then when they come out right, put them into a tin.
Yeah.
Because you can pre-make all this stuff, can't you?
Yeah.
Because it's got quite a good shelf life, these products, haven't they?
Yeah, definitely.
And it's lovely.
And then all we need to do, the little bits that we cut off, we're not going to waste those either, because they make great little fillers. So if you think there's an area like that one, that I think actually that would benefit from an extra petal in there.
Oh, so you can lose all your waste.
Yeah, apart from the centre. Well, you could cut the centres down as well if you want to, but I don't need to on this one, I don't think.
And do you know what I love about it? You haven't had to worry about the flower shape because the dye's done the
work
for
you.
And when you buy something like a dye, it's a tool, isn't it? You just have got it forever.
Yeah, definitely.
So don't use it for paper crafting and cake crafting, you know? Just that's the big thing I'm going to say, just for food safety, really.
Where's that one going to go?
Me putting them on.
I'm going to put it in there, I think. Just curl it ever so slightly. And
that's
think,
amazing.
Yeah,
this looks lovely,
I'm okay with that one. So I'm going to leave that to dry. Let's put that out of the way.
A rose, lily rose.
I think that's it, isn't it? I mean, actually, if we just go to that finished one.
This one here?
Yeah, the little spiky flower. That's been made in exactly the same way. But it's an entirely different flower, so it's more like a little sort of water lily, but exactly the same technique, just
Beautiful.
By reducing the amount of petals each time.
And if we notice in the centre here, I don't know if you can get on top of here, we've still got that little bit of work that we started on the show when we used the stencil. You don't have to stencil the whole cake. Sometimes you get a feeling that you've got to do the whole thing and repeat the pattern. Look at that. A little bit of stenciling in there, a few roses, and of course, more if you have a stencil with a vine leaf, that's all this is. There's no piping work involved here. It's all using the tools we're showing you today. And a little bit of time and a little bit of patience. Love that. Now then, as promised, when we're doing a demonstration, we like to sort of recap it with the products that we use. Started with the Tatterlace Lavish Blooms Lily Cake set. That's a three-piece set in there, 366698. We also use the amazing crossover to cut them out. And obviously, if you're cake making or if you're cake decorating or paper crafting, this is great for you. 341952. And that includes the plates, accessories and instructions. Now that's on FlexiPay as well. So if you wanted to open a sexy flexi basket in the Cake Academy, you can do that. Now, the cut tidy, we said, keep some for your cake decorating. It is 352410. There's 10 sheets of the cut tidy, and the edible die cutting with 3 additional 5 sheets in there as well. So, great value on that one today. The wafer paper, don't give it to the dog.
362625. A fabulous thing. So it acts the same as paper, but it's edible. And we've used it in the show to make a beautiful flower, and there's 10 A4 sheets in this set. And we started the show with stencils. We just used one with the whole collection here, the variety pack of cake stencils. Six designs. The item number you need, 366702. And remember, all these items are available on our website, crankcraft.tv, along with other information about the Cake Academy and also information about Cake Masters, that subscription magazine you can join for 12 months of inspiration. But let's not forget the tools. I keep going about the tools. They appear every single week, and that's all must have. Set of eight here, double-ended modelling tools. 328782. There's a whole range there. Even those eight, the 16 tools. And the rainbow dusts, the painted colours, 352411. And the brushes that Rosella was using, you can use yours. There's lots of different ones here. You can go from a chisel brush all the way down to a fine detail brush. A five-piece set from Wilton, the experts at cake decorating. That's 351155. You're watching The Cake Academy. So here we go then, back in, I want to call it the kitchen, but it's not, because this is something you don't have to do in the kitchen.
Of course not, no, you can do it anywhere.
You know, in the lounge, or you could do it in the, I suppose in your craft room as well, if you wanted to.
That's where I did mine.
Take all the goodies in the shed.
I want to say shed,
Benjamin. Can I just say that the shed is something like this? It's not like just a shed with a bike in it and a lawnmower, is it? It is a proper crafting shed.
It is, yeah, yes.
Because I don't want people writing in thinking, oh,
not very hygienic doing that in the shed.
On a tin of paint crafting. Now then, next up, we've got another demonstration. We've done the flowers. What we're going to be using
okay,
next?
Okay, so I want the ivy. I'm going to go back to those stencils because then we want some of the foliage.
I've got the
oak leaf dye on the show for some 3D leaves, but then as a flat leaf as well, we want the ivy. And it's beautiful, this. I love ivy. I've chosen this one. So.
It's a really perennial, if you like, stencil pattern, isn't it?
Yeah.
If you think about going back in back to the 90s, we were stencilling everything.
Oh, absolutely. I did. Yeah, my kitchen. Yeah.
Yeah. If it stood still, we stenciled
it.
Yeah, I had a few guys in the workshop that got stenciled in the 90s, and I said, "Don't stand still, because she'll stencil you in the shop."
Oh, yeah.
But there's something about an ivy, because it's just such a lovely pattern, isn't it?
I think that's it, isn't it? And because it flows, and you can get it to flow exactly where you want. Now, when you're now planning it, so you now need to plan exactly where your flowers are going to go, where those leaves are going to go, because it's no good putting your ivy here and deciding your flowers over there, because it just will look...
So a little bit of planning.
Yeah, so my flower is going to go, I think, somewhere around there, perhaps some leaves around here, and then some ivy.
So that's the benefit of making the flowers first. You can actually sort of...
You can place them.
Place them,
yeah,
right.
Okay. Of course you can.
And that looks nice on its own.
Well, it does actually, doesn't it, from there? But actually, that is great, because sometimes when I can't decide the arrangement, and I did it on this one as well, I'll take a photograph of it. So just place them, take a photograph, and don't look at the cake, look at the photograph, because for some reason, it gives it a different perspective, and it looks...
And we've all got that technology, and most of us got the technology, you know, take your phone, take a picture, say, oh, that looks really well. And also keep it.
Yes.
And also take a photo of the finished sample as well, because sometimes you forget.
Will you do it? And actually, I put the flowers on when I got here today, because I thought it would be easier to transport. So I just go back to my photograph, like, oh, yeah, that one wants to go there, and attach them. So, ivy. I'm happy with it there. Now, the stencils are really, really pliable, which means that I can sort of go over the edge with them as well.
Okay.
And what I can do, I won't on this one, but you can actually mask them off as well. If there's an area you don't want to go to, then by all means mask it off as well. So we'll start by, and a little bit more of a paint on this one. And the reason being, it's got these really fine sort of centres on there.
They're like the vines.
The veins,
the veins,
that's
the vines,
it.
The
yeah.
veins. Same word.
It is.
Same
it
letters,
is.
In a different,
different
order.
Different order, that's right.
I knew what I meant.
And I like the fact that it isn't necessarily very even.
Do you know what that's the lovely thing about these beautiful powders as well? It's as it runs out, it's almost like an auto blend. You don't even have to know how to blend and how to do all
Not
those sort of
all.
Things an artist would do, because as it runs out, it sort of blends away. So don't keep dipping. I think the fact that you sort of use the brush and just let it run out is a perfect way of blending it and the shading, isn't it?
It is.
It's lovely.
And I'm just going to go over the edge there, and then I'm going to bend that one round to go over the edge.
Yeah.
So don't worry at all that it's you're sort of moving it around, because that's perfect, because then you've got
that's
the
cool,
whole... I know.
Can I just turn this
of course
the
you can, yeah.
Look. See, just falling over the edge. It's lovely.
So, and then we'll have some more. Now, what I do tend to do is just keep a little bit of kitchen roll. You could wash them after each one, but in my shed, I don't have a sink. So what
I
just...
have to come up for a different name for your shed.
What do you think?
Can we go crafting cabbing?
We could do, but then...
What size is it?
That same size as this, I suppose.
That's not a shed, is it? That's an extension.
Yeah, it needs an extension. I know that people like me, if your craft room's anything like mine, you certainly need an extension.
Is it larch lap or is it a log style?
It's a log style.
Oh, well, it's not a shed, really. Is it really? It's more of... It's a chalet, more than
a chalet, do you think?
A chalet, because if it's larch lap, if it's joint again, it's more than a shed. Anything over 10 by 8 is more than a shed.
It was actually a necessity. So when Henry was very small, so when he was about 2, and...
that's your son, isn't
that's
it?
My son.
Just so people know, he's not
yes.
a dog or
anything. Yeah, not the husband, just is that my son. And I used to do a lot of beading for... I used to put it into sort of boutiques and things and make commissions, and I'd made a bracelet for someone. It would take me 30 hours. And he was 2, and he got the scissors, and he went... And part of me was so thrilled that at 2 he was that dexterous he could cut this bracelet up.
Yeah, but super parenting scissors.
Yeah, I know.
But you got into the craft room.
But no, this was before I had it, so then that was it.
Oh,
I needed it, didn't I?
So you said, listen, I need a 30 grand log cabin.
Oh, I wish.
Is that what you said?
I can imagine how well that would have gone down.
Yeah, and he said, well, I'll tell you what I'll do. Just you can go outside, here's your budget.
Right, now, can you see,
lovely.
I've got white veins in
yeah.
there. Well, of course, you can go over this with different colours.
Because so you can replace it again.
Of course you can.
Right,
you can pop it
okay.
back over just to sort of keep it in place. Let me just, again, if you can keep sort of dabbing that powder off, because occasionally it will
okay.
sort of migrate onto
Wouldn't
the white
sense,
icing. In which case, then you put a butterfly or something over it, so that's absolutely fine. So you could go over that with a little bit of gold. I've got another brush there, actually. What colour's that got on? Pink, that's okay. And just to give it a little bit of tone. If you then take your stencil off, you'll then have gold veins as well, won't you?
Very nice. So you can sort of don't be afraid to sort of go sort of freestyle, as it were.
Absolutely. Just play and put some extra on. It just gives it a little bit of a shine,
Look,
that one.
The lovely thing about cake decorating, I think, if it goes wrong, you
can
eat it.
That's what Franny said at the end.
That's as simple as that, isn't it? When it goes wrong, you just eat that bit. Oh, that's
so
lovely.
I think
it's coming together. Yeah,
yeah, I'm going to leave that. I think because I want to put. I'm just going to put one
more.
Yeah, sorry, a little bit more, just round the corner. And I only want the small leaves on this one, so I'm just going to place some of the smaller leaves.
So in this set, you get sort of a collection. So you do get the sort of the ivy, and you get some other textures and patterns as well. So it's a good starting point, isn't it?
Well, yes. I mean, I've chosen these specifically that I thought went together, and they're different size stencils as well. So they're useful
Lovely.
Perhaps for cupcakes. They're useful for large cakes. And you'll notice with the samples around, I've actually used them to paint with as well. There's a plaque somewhere tumbled. Oh, behind near the weighing scales.
I'll come get it in a minute.
So I had obviously had a second set of stencils for that.
If you've got a stencil, this could be the third tier of a three-tier cake. Because you can keep moving it and moving it and moving it,
yep.
the pattern can be as big or as small as you want it to be. So if you want to start with a little birthday cake and then you go on to sort of larger cakes, you never know where it will end.
Well, and also this could be the 10th cake I've done like this. Because you've got the tools there, you can just recreate it should
them.
You wish to.
Yeah. So, I mean, you just go 3 tiers of the same thing even would do, wouldn't
yep.
it? The cascading thing. Absolutely fantastic. And even a shop-bought cake sometimes, you think, well, I've actually, I'll do a little bit of the Christmas cake particularly.
Yes.
You know, if you want to do, because people like to do their own, get it covered, but you can get a white one. We take all the paraphernalia off
yes.
it. Yes. And do your own design.
Exactly. Put some of that ivy on. Make some Christmas roses
yeah.
to go on there.
Make
you
them
can
red.
Do it. Yeah,
so
absolutely.
So like a poinsettia style as well. You could do that, couldn't you?
Yep. So that's, I think, all the painting done
Stage
on that.
Stage 2,
exactly.
as it were. Now,
yes.
as always, promising here at the Cake Academy, you can get all of these items on our website. At the moment, we've got the variety pack of cake stencils on your screens right now, which is 366702. And remember, it's all there for you. And when you go to the website, go for a little search around the Cake Academy. We've got all sorts of tutorials there and lots of help and inspiration, really. That's what it's all about, is get you started. And that's what we want to do. So, next Stage 3, then.
I think we need a ribbon around it, don't we?
A ribbon. Just tie a ribbon, because you know what? If you've made your own cake as well, what I like about this next stage of this, if it's a bit ropey around the edge,
yes.
because you can get the top smooth a lot of time, and you've got those smoothers, there's all the tools you can get. But occasionally, it is a little bit, it's gone a little bit, what should I say, saggy.
Well, sometimes a little bit touched and overlooked
so
a bit.
So we can now disguise that, can't we?
Well, we can. Now, I know there's lots and lots of ways of putting ribbon around cake. The first thing I'm going to do is actually put one around, and then I'm going to tie a bow. So I've chosen this green.
It's beautiful.
Because it's got that gold tinge, which is why I've then tied that in with the ivy.
And straight away, that looked great.
Well, it does, doesn't it? We haven't done anything with it yet. No. So I'm just going to cut that to an approximate size. Now, if maybe I was at home, I might pin this. I'm going to leave this here for in case anybody would like to eat it, and I don't want them to eat my pins. So what I'm going to do is a bit of parchment.
Suddenly everyone's interested.
You see? Yes.
Cake. Okay. What type of cake is it? It's sponge?
This is Madeira cake, yes.
A Madeira cake. Yeah. So not the cheap one. It's Madeira cake.
It is.
Madeira cake.
Madeira, oh my goodness me. I asked for that, didn't I? I should have just lied, shouldn't I? I said it was a fruit.
I would have had a gag for that.
You would, wouldn't you? So what I'm actually going to do is I've got a little bit of parchment then. Excuse me, that could be baking parchment. I've used parchment because it's white.
Okay.
Perhaps if you've got a coloured cake, then a bit of greaseproof paper, something like that.
Yeah.
And I'm going to just take this double-sided tape off.
Lovely.
Get rid of it, I don't want that. Get off. And put half of the ribbon on there.
Oh, clever. So, as my nan would say, oh, you clever stick.
Well, it just stops then the ribbon being in contact at all. Now, just a minute, I just need to place that back on there again.
Oh, I see. We're planning again, aren't we?
Yeah, my bow's going to come around this side. But because I'm actually going to attach it to that parchment the other way around, it means it will actually slide around a little bit as well. So that's okay.
Okay, lovely. So we're not sticking it to actual cake?
Nothing stuck to the cake at all. It will just actually slide off should we wish it to.
And we need it at one point.
It will, yes,
because
it will definitely come away.
When the knife is out, that ribbon has to come off.
Most definitely.
Now, what about a bow then?
That's what we need.
It's the thing that strikes fear into people,
isn't
it?
Well, you know, it's so easy, isn't it?
I know what I'll do.
Go on.
I'll buy one.
Go on.
That's what people say.
Well, it's true, isn't
it? I'll go and buy
one. Yeah, I'll buy one that's ready-made with a ribbon attached.
And you've got the ribbon, you said, why not make one?
Yes, I mean, maybe the ribbon is something special. Perhaps it's from a present or something. It's a thank-you cake for that present, if it was nicely done up in ribbon.
When does it end?
Exactly.
A thank-you cake for the thank-you cake.
Well, exactly. It could go on forever. Why not? I haven't got a problem with that. So, Stacey Bow I'm going to do. So okay. I'm going to do it nice and slowly. If you've never used a bow maker before, then, and I'm right-handed, if you're left-handed, then do it the other way around.
Okay.
And all I'm going to do is first I'm going to attach the tail in the left-hand slot. It doesn't matter which slot I use, but the left-hand one. And I need to cross the middle. So if you are left-handed, you want to cross the middle in the other direction.
Right.
And I'm going to go right to the end of the bow maker here and just go down through that end slot. And then I'm going to go across the back and I'm going to come back up the same slot at the other side. No, I'm not. I'm going to do a Stacey Bow, I just said, didn't I?
Mm.
Right, forget the way I said that. I'm going to go to the end. Then
that's why we can series link this
fast forward to this one. Up the middle. And then down at that slot at that end.
Okay.
And then up the middle. And then back down where you started.
Right.
Back up the middle.
Yeah.
Back down to that end. Now, you can continue as much as you want.
And it's all about layers of ribbon.
Absolutely.
Bow now,
so I've now got two loops on my bow. If I'd like more loops, I can do that. It's not a problem. But I think two will do for this. So back up the middle, and then I'm going to tuck the ribbon, just to keep it under control, in the slot at the right-hand side.
Okay.
And I'm just going to cut the end off. I'm not going to worry about it being neat at this stage because I'm going to trim it again when I've tied the bow.
Okay.
Release the tail that you've just put in. And go down through that centre hole in the bow maker. And that sort of organise it now. You're going to turn it over. It's going to go back through that centre slot.
Look, already you can see it coming
you
together.
You can do, can't you? You can see where the bow's coming from. And then at this point, you can lay it on the counter, which means that you can then tie the knot.
Normally, you're trying to hold it with three fingers, tie
That's
it with the
it.
Other one, pull it tight, pull that through. One bend's bigger than the other.
Yep.
But how about can I offer you perfection, ladies and gentlemen? Any chance?
Absolutely. And the same. So perhaps this cake's going to have four or five or six bows. They can all be exactly the same bow.
Mm.
Make your tails nice. On this one, I'm going to just do a little fish tail on there. So just fold it in half and don't cut it that way. Cut it the right way. Goodness sake. We all do it.
Do you know what? I'm glad you've done that because whenever I try to do fish tails,
always.
My little brain's going,
Yeah.
Think about it. Think about it.
Think about it, and then totally ignore it. And then that's it.
Slide it off.
You're there.
Do you know what? Think of this, right, at this point here. A piece of wire or a little body, you can make dragonflies out of these, butterflies out of these. These can be many different... That's a butterfly in your hand right away.
Well, it is, and it could just as easily go on the top of the cake as well. And it would look really pretty. Yeah. It would actually look really pretty on there, wouldn't it? So look at
that. Job done. And you haven't really done very much,
really.
It's very basic skills.
It is.
You know, get two or three different bows, one on the top. And it's just all these things that you just take for granted that you're making at home. Bow maker details, again, on your screens right now if you want to get one of those. I know that one of our staple items in our home now.
Well, I think so. I mean, I've got them with the present wrapping. Okay, I'm going to struggle with this one, do you?
You don't have to worry about the food safe thing with this bit either, because you can use that in your craft and, of course, across your cakes as well, can't you, say?
Well, you can, but by all means, get one into the kitchen as well as...
We've got one in the craft box and one in the...
I'm going to leave you with that one. Oh,
brilliant.
Just have a play with that, will you, for
Thanks.
Me? And if not, can you manage that? If not, I'll put a bit of tape on this one.
You get the whole cake, and the other thing you can't do is get the poker
can't get the poker tool. I have got a poker tool somewhere.
What about in your satchel?
No, there you go. Just there. Because I thought, I'll put the pokey tool out because I'll need that.
Now you're going to wait and watch me now. Just, can you do something else?
Yeah, I'll put a bit on the ribbon just in case you don't get it off. How's that? It'll be a race to see who gets this. I don't know what Magic Hands is laughing at. I'm going to give it to him next.
Yeah, this is proper, this, isn't it? Oh, stay on there. Right,
okay.
For all the people upstairs, I don't know what exactly I'm trying to do. We've put red double-sided tape on this, ladies and gentlemen. I've got the first bit off, and now we're trying to get the red sticky bit back off the back so we can stick the bow on. Why don't you stick it on there? I can do that.
Yeah, I'll give you that one. So, when we've actually got our bow on there, at some point in the future, we'll be able to attach that bow to our cake. And then it'll be time to also put the flower on the cake. Now, we've got a die on the show for leaves, and I think actually I'm going to have... I'm going to stand over here for a moment, and I'm going to have two or three leaves on there as well. So, again, back to that wafer paper.
And OK, again, while I'm skillfully taking this off, ladies and gentlemen, here are some of the items that you may want to purchase to help you create these wonderful creations that we're creating today. 366698 is the Tattered Lace Lavish Blooms Lily Cake die set. That's the one we opened the show with, making those wonderful flowers for the top of our cake. Also the cut tidy, which means don't have all the bits all over the floor. Buy some for your cake cutting on its own. The 10 sheets of cut tidy for edible die cutting. Also with three additional 5 sheets in this particular offer. Hooray! And then the wafer paper, the 10 A4 sheets of that edible wafer paper, which is making the lovely flowers. And, of course, you can decorate, you can paint with the powder, which I saw earlier on. Coming to you, 362-625 is the number you need to jot down. The stencils, a whole row of these have got some flower stencils, you can see there. There's actually a bouquet and ivy and, of course, the design and the sort of trellisy style design that we started the show with. The whole collection, 6 designs, 366-702. Now the bow maker, an absolute must as far as I'm concerned, the Embellishment Attic Bow Maker. Now this comes with a magazine as well, and a sparkly midi and mini bow makers. You get a couple in here in the set and they clip together. So you've got all different sizes of bows for your cakes. 340-069. And now ribbon. Now we're going to give you some options here. They're not the one that actually Rosella used, but this is 4 rolls of organza ribbon. Really delicate, very, very sort of cakeish, if you don't mind using that word. Contents may vary on this one, but you will get 10 metres. Now the tools for the job. These are the set of 8 double-ended modelling tools, well worth going for, because obviously being double-ended you get 16 tools in total. I won't go through them all, but you can see on your screens there pretty much everything that you're going to need, not for just this Cake Academy show, but subsequent Cake Academy shows as well. 352411, give us the rainbow dust. It's the painted colours, so you get some fabulous colours there, your greens, your reds and your yellows. 352411. And let's end with the brushes. So if you'd like to brush your dusts on, or maybe anything else that needs a paintbrush, these are the ones from Wilton that we absolutely have heard of before with the Cake Academy. 351155. And of course, Cake Academy every Sunday at 5 o'clock.
But the funny thing about that is,
I actually said that on the last Cake Academy and had an email from the lady that organises all this and gave me the running through, Dean, this is what you're doing. I sent him a bank, yes, I've done four of these, I know what I'm doing. Obviously not.
Just don't know what day it is.
Failed miserably. If you are watching this on sort of a repeat, or if you're watching because you've downloaded it, the series linked it, it's Sunday, 5 o'clock. Can I just say that? I don't know. So then, more, please.
OK, so the oak leaves, exactly the same as we did before. I've already cut some out here because I can't cope with just one. I need
three.
Look at
the detail of these.
But this is just the vein, but they make a really great filler. So I'm just going to cut the last one out.
Look at those. Aren't they gorgeous? Look at those.
Really, really pretty. I'm going to hide the acorn on this because it's not an autumnal cake at all, but of course it's going to look fabulous, and you could do a wreath, couldn't you, in autumn?
Oh, wow. Obviously, if you cut lots and lots and lots of them out, and of course with those sheets you're getting in that pack that we showed you earlier on, you're getting lots of choices because you just keep cutting and cutting and cutting. But you can cut and keep, as I call it, in Cake Academy, which means put them in a tin or a box or whatever it may be for another time. So you could just have a session cutting, couldn't you?
Yep. Definitely. And again, let's just go back to those rainbow dust. Let's just colour these as well. So keep it nice and tidy.
So it's very nice and calm in the Cake Academy.
Oh,
I
yes.
like the Cake Academy.
Yes, I do.
This is how calm it is. Nice and relaxed. No stress.
No. No, now that we've managed to attach that bow, then that was it, really.
Definitely.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you go through the cake department, you don't even have to go through a sort of a posh cake department. You go to the posh end of the market. But if you just go into your supermarket, you can see how much cakes cost pre-done, particularly if they've got a theme.
Yeah.
They're very, very expensive.
Yeah.
And there's no satisfaction there. I know we've all done it, we've all had to do it. But if you are someone that's very creative and someone that likes to bake, I'm going to the next level now, thinking, oh, I'm not very good at all that other stuff. This is where the Cake Academy is going to come in, teaching you not only how to do it, but offering you tools. I think that's most important, because I think if you've got the right tools, because half of the pros, you know, what I found out, they're very good, and I'm not going to, you know, I'm not saying that because obviously they've trained, but they do use the right tools.
I think, yeah, definitely. As anywhere, I mean, it's like the crossover. This is perfect for the Cake Academy, because on wafer paper, I don't necessarily need a lot of pressure like you mentioned.
No.
It means that I can actually reduce the pressure so that I know that I haven't got a problem
choice,
with it.
Yeah, absolutely. Because I know that particular with the crossover, and I think it's one of its main sort of, they call it USPs, isn't it? It's a unique selling point, is the fact that you could adjust that pressure. So we are incorporating all crafts with that, aren't we?
Yeah, definitely. So it's time to put it together, Dean.
Lovely.
So we've got our bow on there, finally. We're going to have our little flower on there. I'm just going to put it towards me so I can organise it. And then I'm going to pop some of these leaves then over there.
Really achievable, look at that.
And we'll have this one here. Then we can't have it. There we go. Can't have it equal because that wouldn't be right either.
And you can't do four.
And I can't do four, no. I just
can't. We've got the garden theme here. All odds, everything's odds, looks better in odds.
Yep. And I'm just going to attach a little bit of glue on the flower there. And then I can put the leaves underneath. There we go, this one. And again on this one.
So we've got about 10 minutes left on the show.
Yep.
So it gives us a time to not only get this finished up, we've also got a little cupcake deal going on for you. So, because sometimes you can just buy them, but wrap them well.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
So it isn't always about decorating the cake from scratch. It's about maybe, it's also, what's the word I'm thinking of? Embellishing what you already have.
Definitely.
Should we say that?
Yeah.
It's pretty, isn't it? Look at that.
It's pretty, but it does need some cupcakes around it, doesn't it? For our party. So.
Are all the cupcakes fresh today, Rosella?
They are.
Oh, fabulous.
They are.
One keeps winking at me.
Now, that's our finished, our main item of the show, isn't it? Our main
cake. So remember, we've shown you every single item that we've used to make this cake. There's not many of them. They're all available on the website. Look at that, from the flour to the stenciling to the ribbon itself. I'm going to put this over here as part of the end of show, what they call their wrap party.
Yes,
that's going to happen at the end of this Cake Academy.
Definitely.
Fantastic. Now then, let's talk about the next day. Things that you could just maybe buy and embellish.
Yep.
And cupcakes have been massively popular over the last couple of years.
They have. And perhaps Magic Hands would pass me a chocolate one, because I've got a chocolate one on the counter.
Got one. Magic Hands. Could we possibly have a chocolate cupcake, please?
The whole plate will do, if not. That would be perfect.
Hello.
So, now, the reason being, I want to show you this, because this is a flower. Now, this is the Lavish Blooms Lily.
That looks like it's made out of paper, fabric almost.
Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it? So, Lavish Blooms Lily, and then the little centre of that is the centre from our sunflower doily, because, of course, you need a doily if you've got a cake as well, don't you? But I'll show you that in a moment.
So this is the bit underneath here. We've actually done the plate as well.
We have, but I'm going to show you that little cupcake wrap to start with.
OK, so we've bought these, as we can, nice and simple. You can go as far with this as you want to, or just keep it quite simple. But I do like wraps. Now, I had a friend who was making cupcakes for what I'm still doing, but it was the bits like the wraps and that she had to send out to get done.
Well, absolutely.
Because she could do a cake decoration, but she had to pay someone. Then, of course, she'd add her little bit of thing onto it. That's the bit that really put the price up, was the wrap, which was really weird. Because we had our names in them and all sorts of things.
Oh, how lovely.
For Christmas, I did them all, and we all had our name on our wrap.
Yeah, so you knew exactly where everyone was sitting.
I think that's a lovely idea. Of, you know, Jack and George and that sort of thing. I had George's, obviously, because he was young at the time. No, he was a baby. Cake. But couldn't leave them out. So if you did, that's done straight away.
So that's it. So it comes cleanly out of there. And I'm sorry, Tom, I'm going to make a mess on time.
No, using paper now, Rosella, or are you going to?
I'm going to go straight for paper now. You can cut this in rice paper and colour it. Of course you can.
And eat it.
So it doesn't matter. It means that everything on the table then. So particularly perhaps if you. I'm sorry. Sorry, Tom. But if you are doing children's parties, you don't need to worry about them popping something perhaps in the mouth that you didn't necessarily want in their mouth. So a bit of paper. Oh, in fact, there's nothing to come out of there. Now, on this wrap, one of the really nice things on it, I'll just put it against the green, it's got little distinct butterflies in there as well. So we could then have these little butterflies on top of the cake as well.
So it's weird, because when you see that shape, you don't think it's going to be round.
No, you don't,
It's really bizarre, isn't it?
What is going on there?
The perfect shape, because it needs to be tapered and round, doesn't it?
It does, otherwise it won't sit nicely, will it? And it's even got a small slot at the end there that you can then feed the end of your paper through, she says, in confidence. There we go. I've managed 11 others today, but...
Isn't it funny? The one that's live on the TV will be the one that you
struggle with. That I can't manage, yeah, absolutely.
Well, you've got a cake to put in it.
Well, I haven't actually, have I? Oh. I would have had a spare, but then my daughter came and said, Mummy, they look nice, don't they?
And then it, 12
And so
became
12
11.
Became 11. Thank you, Franny.
You'd anticipate that. Trust me, 11's going to become 10, 9, 8, 7 and 6
It certainly is, isn't it?
When this show ends in about 7 minutes' time.
I'm not going to mess about with that. So there we go. And then all you do is literally, if I just take that one back off again.
Aren't they just amazing?
They just
aren't they just so individual? They're the sort of thing that you'd be proud of.
Don't let it open up like that. Fasten it properly.
Drop them in. But the thing about these wraps is you can do a colour coordination, you could do texture, you can do anything you want, because the nice thing about paper is, as we know from paper crafting, if you have all those tools like embossing folders, etc., you can go to town. And things like mirror board and all the texture of the castle. I was at the Hobbycraft show, as I say, the last couple of days, and I just know there's so many things. And we've got a die like this, it can cut them all, can't it?
Of course it can. But of course then, we talked about that little butterfly, didn't we?
Yeah.
Well, we could just cut that little butterfly out, couldn't we? So I'm going to go for the cut tidy on this one.
Right.
And I'm going to put my rice paper within there, as I've just been...
Because I wonder about the cut tidy. I bet home's thinking, why did you use the cut tidy?
There you go.
And then you're going to cut
I'm going to cut the edible wafer paper. I'm just going to get rid of my bits. Oh, Tom, I'm so sorry. Not that sorry.
She's not sorry at all.
Not is she? And then choose which butterfly I want to cut. I think it's that one there.
Okay.
So even just a small scrap of your wafer paper then...
And once again, because it's the crossover, you can adjust the setting and adjust the pressure.
Sure.
So you're not really, really cutting into the... Because this is... I mean, almost rice paper in some respects, isn't it? It needs hardly any pressure at all.
No, that's right. Even with the intricate dies. In fact, this is possibly a little bit too much pressure because I turned it up to do the paper, didn't I?
Yeah. So if you've been trying to justify getting yourself some new equipment for your paper craft, you say, well, I will be making cakes and decorating cakes with it, dear.
Yes.
And you'll
be able to eat them. Oh, and I've moved that, Dean. Look at that. I've missed the butterfly entirely. But you can see the idea, can't you? We'll have half a butterfly on here. And because it's a tattered lace dye...
completely missed.
No, I didn't. We only wanted half a butterfly. That was the
plan.
Did
you go out with Sarah?
Oh, honestly, you'd think so, wouldn't you, today? There we go. So, cut round his wings. And he's just going to perch beautifully on there, you see?
Because the thing about the tattered lace dyes, and particularly things like this design, is you can see things in it. If you can see something in it, go ahead and cut it and trim and...
Yep.
Oh, there you go.
And there you go. So then your little half a butterfly. Then.
Half a butterfly.
You can sit against that little bit of flake there, can't you?
Oh, I see what you've done there.
There you go.
There you
go. So it was a plan, really. It was planned that way.
It was planned that way. So it's a little half a butterfly. Can you only see half of it? 366701, the cupcake wrap, a cake die is available if you want to get a hold of it on the website, along with all the other items. And I think as the Cake Academy for this Sunday comes to a close, it might be a nice idea to remind ourselves what's available if you'd like to create what Rosella's created today. 366698, the Tattered Lace Lavish Blooms Lily Cake die set is available. Three dies there. Also, we have the Tattered Lace Lavish Blooms Aster Cake die set. So similar idea, but with a different shape, a different design. You choose. 366700. Now, the Sunflower is one of my favourites. A lovely big die, this one. The Sunflower Doily. So if you want your cake sitting on a doily, on a tea cake, on a tea plate even, that's for you. 696. So keep looking at the cake because I'm not concentrating. We also use the Tattered Lace Autumnal Oak Leaves. Now, remember being oak leaves, but the veins come out. The waste of those is the veins themselves. So absolutely amazing. Take the acorn off and you can use them all for different occasions. And as Rosella was saying, maybe a wreath, something like that. 366697. The one we just used, the Tattered Lace Cupcake Wrap Cake die, 366701 is the item number for that. And do remember that even though we've just used pink paper today, you could use any type of card paper and cardstock colour, etc. Even one acetate and things like that. You can get really, really clever with them. Now then, we started the show with our larger cake and we were using stencils. 366702, the variety pack of cake stencils. There's six designs in there, and we finished it all off with a lovely bow, didn't we?
We did.
Now, if you go for the Bow Maker, you get the magazine as well, because this is the Embellishment Attic Bow Maker magazine with sparkly and midi mini bow makers. So you get two in those, 340069. Next week, Kerry Griffiths will be here in the Cake Academy, bringing you all sorts of different ideas, inspiration. Remember, in association with Cake Masters, you can subscribe and get loads of inspiration throughout the year. So please go to the website, which is creatingcraft.tv, if you'd like to do that. But make sure you set your screens to this show, 5 o'clock next Sunday. Thank you to you, my darling.
Thank you.
And we'll see Rosella very, very soon. But thank you very much for joining us in the Cake Academy. We'll see you next Sunday. Bye-bye.
Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480.